Okay, so I guess that means I should still keep talking until they're ready for me. Before I continue to speak, let me just ask, why not some crowd engagement, you know? Anybody on this side, can you tell me the name of the evangelist? Anybody on this side? Okay, everybody's looking at one another over there. Let's switch to the other side. Anybody on this side, the name of the evangelist? What's the name? Okay, I hope our friend on the other side heard that. So somebody asks them. They don't know, they don't want to answer? You sure? Okay, she's speaking on behalf of all them on the other side. She said that you all are antisocial. And you all were fellowshipping the whole time there a while ago? I don't understand. Let me ask the center section here with Sister Michael and them. Where is the evangelist from? Somebody, no man, you're not sounding good. Where's the evangelist from? Well, you know, I don't think the Trinis are like we Antiguans. I don't think so. So I think when she comes up, somebody can ask her. I think she's going to say she's from Trinidad and Tobago. You know, if you ask somebody, you know, where you're from? I'm from Antigua. Where you from? Antigua. Never Antiguan Barbuda, but thank God for Trinis. They're not like Antiguans. Amen? No amen, but that's okay. The Lord still loves all of us, even if from Antigua, Redonda, or Barbuda, the Lord still loves you. See, they're still having some technical difficulties there. So as we continue this evening, we're going to have a short processional that's going to be done by the evangelist along with the pastor as well, so we can, I don't want to say sit back and relax because that usually causes problems, so just sit and be very attentive as they come in this evening, the platform personnel and the flag bearers as well.
Shall we all stand? Our wonderful, loving Savior, our hearts are filled this evening with gratitude for what you have done for us. We are here this evening, O God, gathered together to hear a word from you. I pray, O God, that your Holy Spirit may fill this place this evening. I pray, O God, that as the word goes forth, that we may hold on to your word, O God, and your Spirit may fill us this evening. And as we leave here, we immerse from this place, that we may immerse alighted with your Holy Spirit, converted and willing to do as you have asked us to do. Bless the proceedings here this evening. May your Holy Spirit cover our preacher this evening, and may this place be hallowed and set aside for the preaching of your word for these moments in history. So bless us now, we pray, in Jesus' wonderful and worthy name. Amen and amen.
They came in not marching. I'm not sure how many of us saw the Congress here on Sabbath. Our pastors are not as sharp as they used to be when it comes to their marching skills. You know, I'm happy that tonight they did not try to display that. You know, they took their time and just gracefully walked across, walked up and walked up. And that's okay. We accept that. A repeat of Sabbath would not have been good. I'm happy for that. I'm happy for that. I want to say welcome to each and one of you tonight. Welcome to the For Such a Time as This Empowerment Series. And I know God has a message for each of us. Amen? Some of us may have just come here just to listen. Some of us may have just come here just to follow a friend. But God has a reason why you're here tonight. And I know that His word is His word. And He can definitely make a change in your life as well. As we know, our evangelist hails from all the way in Trinidad and Tobago. She took some time away from her life to be here with us. And we're happy that she came. And I hope that the time that she's going to spend with us is going to be very fruitful. And God is going to use her in a mighty way. As we continue tonight, we're going to have a short with his sister Natalia. I'm assuming that she will be coming shortly. So as she makes her way up here, I'm just going to ask persons just for simple host matters that the restroom facilities, they're on the other side in the actual church building. So if you're in need of using the restroom, just go across the road for persons who may need to do that. And if you need some water, I hope that you brought your bottle of water from home as well. The place is a bit warm. So as Sister Natalia comes, I just want to just leave. I'll be back again, but I just want to say welcome to each and one of you. And before I leave, just look at the person next to you and tell them welcome. Just tell them welcome. I said the person next to you, not the person side. You see somebody looking all the way. So the person right here, we look all the way over so far. Just look the person next to you, tell them welcome. That's a little bit better. That's a little bit better. So as we go through tonight, I hope that the Lord will bless us in a special way as His Spirit moves under the edifice tonight. So Sister Natalia will take over proceedings from here on in.
Good evening, everyone. Good night. Thank you all for coming out tonight to worship with us at the Jennings Seventh-day Adventist Church. So we're just going to begin a little thing to get our spirits high and lifted as we go throughout the next 2 weeks under this tent together. So first, I'm going to invite a member of the Jennings Seventh-day Adventist Church, Sister Jacqueline Michael, to come and share her talents. Let's welcome her as she comes.
Good evening, everyone. I'm not singing tonight because I didn't plan to. She told me it's either a testimony or if I choose to sing, but I'll give a testimony tonight about the goodness of God. Anyone here can testify about God, what God has done for them? Anyone? God has been good to me. I have so many testimonies, I didn't know what to say because I know my church people know exactly what happened to me 2009, but somebody out there need to hear what took place in my life. But I'll give a brief rundown. But the Spirit led me to say something different. Well, from 2006, I have been battered, bruised, and torn, but I'm still here. Yes, I can recall that I had a massive blood clot in my foot in my 40s, early 40s. So don't think that you too old or too young not to get something. The devil is always ready to instill things in us, but God is there as our barrier and our head to take care of that situation. And then from all these things happened to 2006, 2007, constant pain that I couldn't take it, that I had to, the Sabbath morning, I had to go to the naturalist to get something to ease that pain, you know. And then 2008, they told me that my blood count went down to 3. They thought I was in a coma, but I'm still here. 2009, I was paralyzed for 20 months, cannot move, you know. I even start a sermon, once a man and twice a child, but I haven't said anything much about that. But God is good this evening to me. And then a couple years ago, I woke up from my bed. I normally wake up early, worship and everything. And going in the kitchen to prepare something for my family, I realized that the gas went. So I went outside, and in going outside, I coming back up. My last son was outside too, so my daughter said, "Mom, somebody's bleeding." So I said, "Who is it?" "Not me." He said, "Not he." But blood trailed from the kitchen to outside, and I didn't realize that I was bleeding. A vein burst in my foot, my left foot. And so when I went in the kitchen, she said, "Mommy, you bleeding, you know." When I look, it's a lot of blood, but I didn't have no fear. I didn't feel that it was blood was coming down. So anyway, I took something up the line and I tied it hard. And I take 2 garlic and then I tell him, "Call the ambulance because I don't know what's taking place." But God had my back and he was there for me. So I waited for the ambulance there, and then almost 3/4 hour, Brother Dale come and he told me that the ambulance will be coming. They never came until another 30 minutes. Took me to the hospital. I sit there all 7 o'clock from since morning early, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, I'm there. Nobody checking me. And to cut the story short, the pressure was 280 over 100 and something. But God is good. I want to let you know that to learn to trust God in the mix of every situation. I could have been dead in the hospital. They forget me to give me a pressure tablet to bring down the pressure. At 12 o'clock, my sister, may her soul rest in peace, she died this year. Dear. She said, "Listen, if you see anything happen to my sister, I'm going to sue you all." and they never gave me a tablet until after 12. Anyway, I took that tablet, and the pressure was still high. It go down, to tell you to say that. If it wasn't for God, I would be under the grave. You know, and then this year again, when my sister died, my mom died in July last year while I was in Dominica, me and my sister went to the States and looked for a family. And she also died in the States when she was about to come on January. She was a teacher at PM school. And then after that, she died. I took it on a little. The pressure gone up again, 275 over 100 and something. They tell me I almost got a stroke. I felt a lump in my head up to this present moment. It is there. But I'm still there. And despite of what the devil want to try to do, I am more than a conqueror. And God has told me that he told me exactly that I have chastised you, but I have not given you over unto death. I want to give God the glory. I want to give him the praise. I want to give him the honor all the time. And I want you all to realize and know that the devil is after us as Christians. So trust God in the mix of every situation. The road may seem difficult and dark and dreary, but whenever you're going through any problem, learn to trust God. Pray without ceasing and continue to live a life that comes in Christ. And God will see us through. May God continue to bless each and every one. Amen.
Good evening, church. Tonight, I too have a testimony to share, but it's in song, and it's simply me being thankful for God's grace. I don't know where I would be without it. I don't know where you would be without it, but thankfully, Christ came and he died. He paid the price so that we didn't have to. So thank you, Lord, for your grace. Measured out my days, life carrying me along. In my soul I yearned to follow God, but knew I'd never be so strong. I looked hard at this world to learn how heaven could be gained, just to end where I began, where human effort is all in vain. Were it not for grace, salvation up to me, I know how that would go, and all the battles I would face, I'd be forever running, but losing the race. Were it not for grace, it's expressed with all my heart, offered to a friend who took my claim. God start, and when he saw in full just how much his love would cost, he still went the final mile between me and heaven so I would not be lost. For God's grace, oh, I can tell you where I'd be wandering down some pointless road to nowhere with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. All the battles I would face, I'd be forever running but losing the race. God, were it not for grace, I'd be forever running but losing the race. For grace, oh God, for your grace.
Good evening, everyone. Well, good night, everyone. We are bringing down our mini concert, and we are going to give God praise. We know concert has this thought that you're supposed to sit and listen to us sing, but we want you to join us as we sing, "You're Worthy of It All." All the saints and angels bow before the throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing.
Amen. Amen. Okay, at this time, I'm going to ask all the visitors to stand. If you think you're a visitor, just stand quickly for me, please. All the visitors, please stand. Amen. Put your hands together for them. I don't want to miscount. Am I seeing two? Three? Is that three? Nobody help me count. Is that three? That's a resounding yes. I hope this is not your first and only time. Make sure you're back tomorrow and the night after that and the night after that. And then I think it's going to be day. And then the night after that again. And don't just come by yourself. Make sure you bring a friend as well. And for the persons who are here tonight sitting, well, since nobody over here is a visitor, that's a good thing. So now you have some work to do. Sorry? Brother Mervyn, you a visitor? Oh, there's a visit. Can we have an usher in that section for me, please? She did not stand. I did not realize. My apologies as well. So that way we have some work to do. Just bring somebody else. You don't want you to get the message for yourself alone. You can have a seat now. Thank you so much for coming again. And remember, don't just come by yourself. Bring somebody else as well. Don't keep all the good stuff to yourself at all. Amen, brethren? Nice to see you, Brother Murphy, despite you have some challenges there with your hand. As we continue tonight, I'm going to ask, do something very quickly. I'm going to ask five ladies just to come to the stage quickly. Five females just to come to the stage. And please don't let me to call you, because I know everybody's name on here now. Believe it or not, I know every single person's name. So five volunteers, can you just come quickly? Five females. Sister Jerry, I see you walking fast. You're one? No problem. Come straight up, Sister Jerry. Come. Thank you so much. Five females. I need four more. Any four? Nobody is a female. I think the church is full of too many. Yes, that's two. Sister Jean Marie, that's you there? Who's that there? That's okay, Sister Jean Marie. It looks like, but she's going the wrong direction. Anyway, we need three more females. Any three quickly? Three females. Okay, I think I have to go for some names right now. Sister Joseph, that's you there? Sister Joseph, that's you? You're looking straight at me, not answering me. Sister Joseph, come right up. Thank you so much for coming, Sister Joseph. Let me do a quick scan again. Come, Sister Joseph, thank you so much for coming. The other Sister Joseph that's trying to hide from me as well, behind there in that nice pink shirt there, ducking on the chair. Yes, I see you. Come, Sister Joseph, I see you as well. Yes, you're looking at me smiling. Yes, you, Sister Joseph, come as well. Let me scan across here now. Who's the next person now? I see Sister Jarvis watching me, but I won't call her Sister Jarvis, so don't worry. Don't worry, Sister Jarvis. Just need one more. Yes, yes, yes. Sister McDonald, come right ahead. Yes, you. I see you told somebody he's going to call my name. Yes. Thank you so much for saying that. Come right ahead, Sister McDonald. So we're going to do a short exercise. I want you to see them properly. Hold a second. Come right up, Sister McDonald, quickly. All right, so Sister Parker, I think you have a paper bag there for me. If you can just bring it for me, please. All right, so what we're going to do quickly, by virtue of the crowd, not by God, because God loves all of them, and all of them are beautiful in the eyes of the Lord. Amen? But just for tonight's purposes, we just want to know who you think is the... We're going to go to, we're just going to go by default. Who you think is the most elegant looking lady right now? No, they didn't come for this purpose. That's correct? But I see they're smiling and blushing and everything. The camera's on, you know, so that's good. Just keep the smile going. So now we're going to start and we're going to use applause, you know, just keep clapping. So we're going to start with Sister Jerry. Sister Jerry, still single and looking. Look at her, single and looking. Look into the camera, yes. So what do you think about Sister Jerry? Sister Jerry is the one? Sister Jerry, you have some fans in the audience. All right, let's go on to Sister Michael, who was telling us that she had some challenges a few years ago, but she's on her legs now. Married and not looking. They like the leopard. All right, we have the other sister, Sister Joseph, who's watching me very hard. She's single and... Well, okay, she's Sister Joseph. What do you think about, let's hear it for Sister Joseph. The applause are getting louder. I think by the time we reach the end, somebody's in problems. We have Sister Joseph just hiding behind the Antigua flag. And yes, I'm hearing some yes. Sister Joseph, you have some fans in the audience. God be praised. God be praised. Let's go down now to our last sing. Yes. Her fingers are free. I don't know if it means single and not looking. Let's hear it for Sister McDonald. All right. So I think those applause were very deep. Sister Parker, what do you think? We're looking just three. Top three. Top three. What do you think? Tell me. Joseph McDonald. Okay, so two Joseph and McDonald. Is that a fair assessment? Is that fair? Yes. So can you just give the two Joseph and the McDonald the prizes, please? And take your time. That's correct. That is correct. Yes. Yes, we have to award a bit. You know, when people do good things, you must give them good things. Too many times, we have too many bad things. Just put your hands together for all of them tonight again. Wait, it's so much? Well, let's give all of them. That's it. So now, we don't go into pageants, but we win something nevertheless. And happy to see that you ladies got a crown. Put your hands together to them as they go back to their respective seats. And there's a crown that can't fit ahead there, but that's okay. We'll get that sorted out shortly. All right, so anybody can tell me tonight's message? Can anyone tell me tonight the name of tonight's message? Is that a no? Can anyone wants to take a try? Other than Elder Joseph, who's trying to share some inside information there. That's treason. Anyone? Okay, so no one's. That's okay, and I think that's a good thing. Maybe, so when the surprises come, it's good. Tonight's message is entitled, "For Such a Time as This." Can you believe it? What's tonight's message? So I'm going to tell you tomorrow night's message. So nobody has no reason not to know. You ready? Tomorrow night's message is entitled, "Dash." What's entitled? Dash. You think you're going to forget that? I hope not. And you tell the person you're going to bring about that message. On Wednesday night, the message is entitled TikTok. What's Wednesday's night message, Brother Hendrix? TikTok. No, Thursday, actually, because today's Monday. They fool me the days and then you're to boy. Because today's Monday. Tomorrow's Tuesday, yes. We'll be going good. And Wednesday's what? TikTok. All right, good stuff. All right, so for tomorrow night as well, we're going to have an initiative as well. And we are going to ask every person to bring an item, a food item. They're going to have a basket or trying to do some packages to give out to some persons in the community. And we're asking person just to bring one item. If you can bring 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, that's fine as well. Minimum one. There was a specific request to ask persons to ensure that the manufacturer's date is on the items. I think some of you are very deceitful, because that's the first time I've seen that. You all have some things that you all got in barrels maybe since 5 years ago, and you rub them off and bring them. That's not good. No. That's not good. Amen? Amen? Amen. Yes, better, yes. So we ask you to bring some good things for us. That's fine? Yes. And I think that's fair as well. So just ensure that you bring one good item that somebody can actually consume without having challenges. So we're asking that for tomorrow night. So bring anything that you want to bring as we pack some packages for some persons in the community. As I mentioned before, for the persons who came in late, the restroom is just on the other side of the road as well. So in the event that you need to use the restroom, it's just on the other side in the main sanctuary. And we're asking as well that persons not to remove the chairs from under the tent and put them on the outside, because we don't want the chairs to go missing or get wet from the inconsistent weather. So just please adhere to that to ensure that the chairs remain under the tent as well. At this time, I'm going to call on Pastor Challenger, who should be coming now to continue proceedings. I'm not sure. Oh, here and here, right here. I'm going to turn you over now. Pastor Challenger, all yours.
Thank you.
The task is mine this evening to introduce to you a young lady. No, don't worry, we haven't come to the evangelist just yet. Another young lady. I'm referring to Dr. Kay White. She serves as the personal ministries and the women's ministries director of the South Leeward Conference. I want to invite her at this time to declare the crusade open. Dr. White.
Welcome. All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Isn't it a joy to be in God's presence tonight? Tonight, I'm very excited to be here in this important campaign. I want to begin by bringing greetings from the administration of the conference, Dr. Carson Green, Dr. Knowles, and Dr. Moore. But even as I stand here, I just want to declare that our God is a loving God. Somebody say amen in this house. Our God is a faithful God. Somebody say hallelujah in this house. And our God is a God we can trust. Amen. And so tonight we've come to lift him up. We've come to magnify him and praise his name. I acknowledge the presence of our ministerial secretary in the house, Dr. Brathwaite. Amen. Put your hands together for him. Dr. Brathwaite, great to have you tonight. I also see Pastor Cindy Lee in the house. Put your hands together for her. The president of the Lay Preachers Federation on Antigua, Elder Clara Jarvis, is in the house. Put your hands together. Elder Vaughn Joseph is in the house. Elder Thomas is. I mean, this place is just full of official people. Put your hands together for all the officials who are in this campaign. Now, this is the biggest event to hit Antigua. But you're quiet like you don't believe it. I said, this is the biggest event to hit Antigua. Now, I'm so excited tonight, I can't even keep still, Pastor Sherwin White. The preacher, I mean, she's a lay preacher. Somebody say amen. I said she's a lay preacher, but she's also a woman preacher. Now, it's not no feminist thing in the house tonight. I said she's a woman preacher. God is ready to use this woman for his glory. Somebody say praise the Lord tonight. And I'm just excited. I need to come off this mic so that the woman of God can come and take her place here. And tonight, it is my honor. It is my pleasure. It is my joy with all the excitement and enthusiasm that I have in me to declare for such a time as this. Let me go back. To declare for such a time like this, empowerment series officially open. We gotta get something on the drums for that, amen. You gotta put, come on, officially open. Put your hands together. Let's get a sound here. And as we get in the sound, we gotta get the drum man. You gotta come. As we get in the sound, I want to introduce the assistant to the president, Pastor. I know you have a lot of energy, so you're gonna run to the stage now. We gotta hear your voice. Put your hands together as he comes. The drum man is gonna. I said it's the campaign is now officially open. All right.
All right, all right. Good night, everybody. Good night, everybody. God is good. And all the time, if you're happy and you know it, say amen. If you're happy and you know it, say hallelujah. If you're happy and you know it, say thank you, Jesus. If you're happy and you know it, say glory. Now, let me just tell you, night after night, you have to make sure that this place is ram, jam, and packed. I know it's a lady who is preaching, so I want you all to go and tell all the men out here, man. Tell the men that a beautiful lady who was born in Trinidad and who lives in Tobago, she is out here. So tell all of the men to come right here. But when they come, you gotta tell them her husband is here. Now, let me just tell you this. I am excited about this here, and let us continue to support. Now, there is a special young lady under the tent. A special young lady. You remember her name? You remember her name? Now, where is Sunita? Pastor, I need a gift for Sunita. Now, this afternoon, Steele and myself, we were at the VC Bird bus. And this young lady, where is Sunita? Sunita, come forward for me, please. Where is Sunita? Where is Sunita? Come, Sunita. Come, Sunita. Now, put your hands together for Sunita. Sunita and her daughter. Now, I'm just telling you this now here. We were there, and she came, and you know what she asked us? She said, can you all tell me how much you have to pay to go to the program? So we said, listen, you don't have to pay a dime. And she said, I'm going to be there, and I'm bringing my daughter. You imagine Sunita say, I went to get my dress fixed so that I could come out here, and Sunita is here. Let us put our hands together for Sunita and her daughter. Ariel is her daughter. Is Ariel is your name, right? Is Ariel? Sunita and Ariel in Jesus' name. And we expect to see you here night after night. Ladies and gentlemen, let us continue to be out here. Tell our friends, tell our loved ones just to be out here. And those of you who are online, we want you to come off of the line and come under the tent in Jesus' name. So God bless you, everybody, in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen. Thank you very much, Pastor White. So you see tonight that we are well supported by the pastoral staff, the pastoral fraternity. Yes, thank you for being here tonight, Pastor Lee. Pastor Lee, I think Pastor Lee served here some time before. Pastor Lee now serves as the pastor of District 8, Antigua, the churches of Freetown, Newfield, and Bethesda. So she's a pastor there. We have in the background as well Dr. Bratwit, who served here before. He is the ministerial secretary of the South Leeward Conference, and he also serves as the communication director as well. And you just heard from Pastor White, who is the youth director. You felt the youth in him, right? Yes, yes, he's the youth director. You can't get anybody to be youth director. You see, like me, I'm too boring for youth director. You have to get somebody with a lot of energy, like Pastor Sherwin White. He serves as a youth director and also the assistant to the president for evangelism. Programs such as these fall under his purview and his office. But tonight, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you a special lady. She has come from far. And she came from far with her bodyguard, her sidekick. Hold on, is the other way around? She's a sidekick or you? My Lord. You know, so when Pastor White was saying that she's a beautiful young lady, he was right. When Pastor White was saying that, you know, she came with her husband, he was right. So tonight, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you a woman of God. Natasha Brown-Alleyne is her name. And she wants to let you know that she loves the Lord very much. But more than saying it to you, you're going to see it in her and how she reacts. She loves people as well. And you're going to see that as well as she interacts with you on a nightly basis. And her favorite passage of scripture is Philippians 4:13. Yes, Philippians 4:13, that wonderful passage of scripture. She is a host of an adult lesson study panel discussion on ASI Media in Tobago on their YouTube channel. She is an ordained elder of the Seventh Adventist Church. She is a lay evangelist, she's a motivational speaker, and she is also an author. She has authored a devotional book called Walking on Water, a powerful, life-changing, inspirational devotional book, an accompanying journal, and it's available on Amazon. So you can go searching for it there. She is an attorney by profession. Can I say that again? She is an attorney by profession. Yes, the lady is a lawyer. She is the wife of an international evangelist. And some of you know who I'm talking about. He's sitting right there. You know, she's beautiful, but he's handsome. Right? But I want to let you know that they're closely knit together. Right? So, yes, you can talk with them, but you can't go only certain so close. Wonderful, wonderful. That's Evangelist Roger Allen. Just stand up and wave to the brethren. Stand up and wave to the brethren. Only a few months ago, Evangelist Allen was here and he really preached the word of God mightily. And many people came to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior through his ministry and preaching. She wants to let you know that she grew up in a fishing village in Mayaro, Trinidad. That's where she grew up. And Charlotteville in Tobago is where she... Roger, grew up in a fishing village in Charlotteville, Tobago. And together, they are fishers of men. And they're a team, they're a fisherman team. My Lord, she holds 2 bachelor's degrees in business and in law, respectively, and a master's degree in law, among other qualifications. But I want to let you know what qualifies her mostly to speak to us this evening, because she is anointed and appointed for such a time as this. I want to introduce to you this evening. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Sister Preacher Natasha Brown-Alleyne. All right, you'll see her in a moment, but I'm asking you now to stand. Could you stand, please, this evening? We want to ask God in a mighty way to come by here this evening and take the body of this woman. It may not be as big as mine, but it has to do a great and powerful and mighty job this evening. Bow your heads with me as we pray. Father, we are thankful that you have brought your daughter by to preach your word this evening. Father, even now I pray that your Holy Spirit may take full control of her, that self may be laid aside, and your Holy Spirit may speak mightily through her this evening. We know that your word is powerful, and when it goes forth, it is able to break down walls of division. It is able to empower us. And I pray, oh God, this evening that we may not leave here the same. So I ask your rich blessings to fall upon us and our hearts even now. Open us up to your word this evening and speak mightily through your daughter is our prayer with thanksgiving. In Jesus' wonderful and worthy name, amen. Please be seated.
Good night, everybody. Tonight, I am here just to let you know that we serve an awesome God, don't we? We serve a mighty God, and we're living in a challenging age, a world where there is so much upheaval currently in Israel and the Gaza Strip. You know what's happening there, between Russia and Ukraine. You know what's happening there. But we know that God has this world in his hands. Amen, everybody? Amidst the challenges of life, even right here in Antigua and Barbuda, where we recognize that there is crime and persons are breaking into homes, but we believe that God has the power to keep us. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, that is why we're here for such a time as this. It's an empowerment series to let us know that God is still in control. Amen, everyone? And while God continues to control the affairs of this universe, we have the opportunity of being here to hear from his word. A program like this, a series like this, does not come just by thinking about it. But it takes a lot of work, a lot of energy, and it also takes some finances to keep it going. Night after night, you'll be here, you'll be hearing the word, we'll be using the electricity, we'll have buses coming by to bring our visitors, we'll be giving gifts, etc., etc. And we want you to know that you can participate in keeping this series going. Do you want to keep this series going? All right, so you can participate in keeping this series going by sharing of your talent and also your treasure. And so we're going to give you an opportunity tonight to share by giving of your treasure tonight to keep this series going. We're going to have the offering, the ushers come by at this time. They're going to join us, and we're going to invite you to give of your means as we support this evangelistic event. And while we are collecting the evening's offering, we will hear from our praise team as they join together in singing our theme song, Our God is Awesome. Our God is what, everybody? He's awesome. So please bow your heads with me even now as we pray. Father, we thank you for the blessings. We thank you for your word. We thank you for Evangelist Natasha Brown-Alleyne and her dear husband who have traveled to be with us all the way from Tobago. We are thankful, God, that you have brought them here to give us hope, to empower us for such a time as this. We know, God, that you have great things in store for your children. So bless us now, even as we give from what you have blessed us with, and may it go a great way in ensuring that the message of salvation is proclaimed to this community of Jennings and Ebenezer. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name, let everyone say, amen.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains, keep me in the valley, hide me from the rain. This is our theme song, so we'll be singing it every night. So we're going to make you get acquainted with it. So you can listen to us and then you can join us as we sing together. Let's sing, My God is awesome.
Good evening, everybody. That's not everybody. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Awesome. I'm seeing people wearing crowns. Oh my goodness, queen. Awesome. So let me see the three queens this evening. Well, the three who were crowned, because we're all queens. So let me see the three that were crowned. I'm seeing only one. I'm seeing two. Oh, three. Excellent, excellent. Well, congratulations, ladies. I'm happy to be here this evening. Good evening, Jennings.
Good evening.
Good evening, Antigua and Barbuda. Amen. I read on the internet that this is one of the Caribbean's most prosperous nations. So they're not in a good place. Yes? I'm in a good place this evening. Somebody knows the internet. So the internet lied to me. That is BBC, you know. BBC is supposed to be reliable, ain't it? I'm Evangelist Natasha Brown-Alleyne. I'm so happy to be here in Antigua this evening. My husband, Evangelist Roger Allen, is in the audience somewhere. Babes, could you come up and say hi to the people? We bring you greetings from the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. Amen.
Hi. Good evening, everybody. My wife said, come and say hi. Hi. Good evening, everybody. We want to welcome you to Jennings in This Is the Right Place to Be at the Right Time. We know you are online. We're just asking you to just take your phone and send a link to somebody because someone needs to hear about Jesus. This woman is about to preach the gospel. And as the Bible says, as John the Baptist says, one must increase and one decrease. May God bless you and have a wonderful evening in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you so much. So special thanks to the Jennings SDA Church, to the previous pastor. I don't want to forget anybody. Pastor Brathway, the present pastor, Pastor Challenger, Pastor Kay White, Pastor Showin White, all the whites. And now I go to the green, Pastor Dr. Carson Green, Pastor Knowles, the members and the Crusade team here at Jennings SDA Church. And to Brother Edson, who's been, you know, liaising with me for such a time as this empowerment series. Turn to somebody and tell them, for such a time as this, I am here. Yes. Yes. Let me see all the visitors in the house. All the visitors, all our esteemed guests. Welcome. Welcome. A special welcome to you. I saw two on this side. Let me see on this side. All our guests, oh, we have a good bit of guests on the side. Welcome. Were you all gifted? Did you all receive a gift? Yeah. Excellent, excellent. That's what I like to know, that you all feel welcome. So please come again and hear my Trini accent. All right? So I take this opportunity to invite everyone within the hearing of my voice to for such a time as this empowerment series. Now tonight you did very well. All right? But tomorrow night, I want you to do better. Amen? Amen? Because tonight, I'm still seeing some empty seats. Right? So tomorrow night, we're going to do better and fill up these seats. Amen? In Jesus' name. So that means you're going to invite your family, your friends, your frenemies, your co-workers, your neighbors, even your enemies. Yes, send them a WhatsApp. They could block you after. Right? But invite everyone to come and be blessed. My reader for this series is Elder Ken Tong. Did I get that correct? Yep. Excellent. So he will be reading with me. I believe in the Bible. Amen?
Amen.
I preach it, thus saith the Lord. So nightly we will be going into the Word of God. And so I ask you to walk with your Bibles. Your phone is not your Bible. Yes? So I ask you to walk with your Bibles. Yes. I believe in the Word of God. I believe the Word of God is true, and that holy men of God were spake rather as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. So tonight and every night you will be hearing directly from the Word of God, because I believe that all scripture, both Old and New Testament, are inspired by God.
Amen.
So I encourage you to walk with your Bibles, your notepads, even your writing material, so you can take notes, and when you're in your free time, you can study it over. do as the Bereans, go home and study again. I also believe in the writings of Ellen G. White and other inspired writers, so from time to time I will also be quoting from them. Those of you who have your Bibles, let me see them. All right, we have a few. Everybody stand with me. Stand with me everywhere. Before we begin our message tonight, stand with me everywhere. Hold your Bibles up in your hands. Holy Spirit, repeat after me. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
We are in your presence.
We are in your presence.
Your word is a lamp unto my feet.
Your word is a lamp unto my feet.
And a light unto my path.
And a light unto my path.
Speak now.
Speak now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. For some women, entering a beauty pageant is intriguing and exciting. Do we have any beauty pageant winners in the house tonight? No? But I read Sister Patrice on the internet again, I hope it did not mislead me, that one Ishikel Corbin, who hails from right here in Antigua and Barbuda, she was crowned Miss JC's International Queen Title 2023.
Correct.
And according to Loop News, she outshined contestants on the British Virgin Islands, Dominica, if you please, Haiti, Montserrat, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and the United States Virgin Islands. I like that they did not say Trinidad and Tobago.
Well.
But many years ago, I want to let you know, I entered into a beauty pageant myself.
Well.
For the Mr. Roger Allen's beauty pageant, if you will. And among all the contestants in Trinidad and Tobago, and my sister, there were many. I award. And so I proudly represent and walk with the crown of Mr. Roger Allen.
Amen.
But friends, you know, sometimes in beauty pageants there are problems. I mean, and I've met my own share of problems, Elder, in winning this beauty pageant for Mr. Roger Allen. I've heard people say, why this Trini come to take the Tobago boy? Yes, I've heard that. So recently we had a situation in Trinidad and Tobago where we had a pageant and a Venezuelan won. So if you were following the regional news, you would have heard about it. And so this made waves. You could imagine our Facebook light up. How a Venezuelan could win Miss Trinidad and Tobago contest? So what they're trying to say? We don't have beautiful women in Trinidad and Tobago?
Well,
so they asked her one day, do you know the watchwords of Trinidad and Tobago? She said, I have to go now. Suffice it to say, she gave up the crown.
Well,
so a Trinidad and Tobago national will now be representing our country in Vietnam later this month for the Miss Grand Trinidad and Tobago beauty pageant. But this evening, I don't want to talk about those beauty queens. I want to talk about another beauty queen, if you please.
Well.
You may not be familiar with her. She was a Jewish nationality. Her life growing up was not too easy. She was not born with a gold or silver spoon in her mouth, if you please. Her childhood circumstances were not ideal. In fact, her parents died when she was very young, leaving her an orphan. Follow me now to the book of Esther. As we kick off this series for such a time as this, empowerment series.
Yes, sir.
My friends, go with me to the book of Esther, the 17th book of the Old Testament. The book of Esther tells the story about Esther, that it's all about God's glory. Did I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
In other words, Esther is not the main character if you read the story very well.
Oh.
God is the main character.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, the book of Esther, like every book in the Bible, is about God.
Amen.
His love, His mercy.
Come on.
His judgment. Mm. His salvation.
Yes.
His faithfulness. His patience, Sister K. His compassion. His providence. His miraculous power. His divine deliverance.
Mm-hmm.
Throughout the book of Esther, the voice of God can be heard.
Yes.
Throughout the book of Esther, the hand of God is revealed.
Yes.
The book of Esther is about courage. It's about strength. It's about faith, resilience. It's even about coping with jealousy.
Yes.
And moving with God's timing.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of my favorite Bible stories and perhaps a favorite for many girls. Do I have some witnesses here this evening? Yes. The book of Esther begins this way. Let's read together with the reader Esther 1, 1 through 4. What does the word of God say?
Now it came to pass in the days of Ahasuerus. This was the Ahasuerus who reigned over 127 provinces from India to Ethiopia.
Yes.
In those days when King Ahasuerus sat on the throne of his
Read with the reader, everybody. Let's go again from verse 2 together. In those days,
when King Ahasuerus sat on the throne of his kingdom, that in the third year of his reign, he made a feast for all his officials and servants, the powers of Persia and Media, the nobles and the princes of the provinces being before him. When he showed the riches of his glorious kingdom and the splendor of his excellent majesty, for many days, 180 days in all.
Now, if they did not tell me that this king was from Media Persia, I would have think or thought that this king was from Trinidad and Tobago because he liked to pet. 6 months a party.
Yes, sir.
Drinks flowing for so. Eats was in abundance.
Wow.
Things were not served on sanitary plates. No, my friends, gold ware, if you please.
Yes.
So imagine a 6 months of feasting. But as if that was not enough, verse 5 tells us that he then held another feast, lasting for 7 days for the common people.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, Queen Vashti hosts another party for women.
Well.
So there's a party for men and a party for women. The king became, the Bible says, merry with wine. In other words, as we would say in our culture, he was drunk.
Yes.
His head was nice. So when his head got nice, he commanded that Vashti be brought to him wearing her crown. I'm not sure if it was her crown alone or if it was the crown with the clothes.
Well.
I'm not sure. But he told, but he said, in order to show off her beauty, crown or without crown, you be the judge. In order to show off her beauty to the people and the officials, for she was beautiful to behold. But Queen Vashti did not go. She suffered dearly for this decision.
Yes.
The king's advisors told him, you've got to do something about that.
Yes.
Do something about that quick. Don't let them other women think they could disrespect men.
Well.
So you know what they did? Queen Vashti was dethroned and decrowned, if you please.
Mm.
The same crown she was called to wear was removed. I want to let you know this evening that sometimes, the crown they place on you.
Come on, preacher.
They will remove it.
Come on. Come on, preacher.
The same people who put it on you.
Come on, preacher.
Will remove it.
Say it again, preacher.
You just go against them once. And they will remove it.
Yes, right.
Esther 2, 1 to 2 tells us. What does the word say? Esther 2, 1 to 2.
After these things, when the wrath of King Ahasuerus subsided, he remembered Vashti, what she had done and what had been decreed against her. Then the king's servants who attended him said, "Let beautiful young virgins be sought for the king."
In other words, some time had passed. And the king said, "All right, let's deal with this now. There is a vacancy to be filled. There's a vacancy of queen to be filled."
That's right.
They sent out application forms throughout the provinces, if you please. And they invited beautiful, fair, young, virgin women.
Well,
don't miss it. If Esther was not a virgin, she would have lost the opportunity.
That's right. Come on.
Young ladies, do I have some young ladies here tonight?
Come on.
I want to ask you, young ladies, in fact, I want to beg you to protect your virginity like fine gold.
Wow.
Do not allow one moment of pressure to rob you of a lifetime of experiences with your husband.
Amen, amen, preacher.
A young woman bought an iPhone one day. So her father saw it and he said, "What was the first thing you did after buying the iPhone?" She said, "Well, Dad, I put an anti-scratch sticker on it to, you know, to cover the phone." He asked her, "Did someone force you to do that?" She's like, "No." "Did you think it was an insult to the manufacturer to do that?" "No. In fact, it was recommended to cover the iPhone to protect it."
That's right.
He piled a little more. "Did you cover up the iPhone because it was cheap and ugly?" "No, Daddy. Actually, I covered it up." You know what this young girl says? "Actually, I covered it up because," and the head moving more than the lips, "I did not want any damage done to it that would devalue the phone." The father continued, "So when you put the cover on, did it reduce the iPhone's beauty?" "No, Daddy. I think the phone looks better with the cover the anti-scratch sticker. In fact, it is worth it for the protection it gives to my new iPhone."
Come on.
The father looked lovingly at his daughter and he said, "If I had asked you to cover up your body,
come on,
which is much more precious than the iPhone,
bring it on,
would you have readily agreed?"
Come on.
Suffice it to say, she went mute.
Well,
fellow young women, cover up your bodies and put an anti-scratch sticker on it, if you please.
Come on now, preacher.
But I know that there are some young women who've already given it up. There is hope for you.
Yes, sir.
There is hope for you. There is always hope in Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You can decide from tonight.
Come on now.
Not to allow anyone else to touch that beautiful place.
Amen.
Until God has given you the husband
Amen.
For you.
Amen. Amen.
God heals. God restores.
Yes.
Cover it up.
Praise God.
And put an anti-scratch sticker on it.
Amen.
I've spoken enough to our young women.
Amen.
Young men.
Aye.
So you all think, well, I could just go and give it up too, and then all I want a nice virgin girl, right? How that will work?
Speak, preacher.
Huh? What the men say, babes? Like what? What? Like what? What? Oh, you see? You see? So in other words, let the men roam.
Yes.
But no. Christian young men, Christian young women, it is for all of us. Cover it up and put an anti-scratch sticker on it.
Amen. Amen.
Let's go back to the word of God. Esther 2, 10 to 11. What does the word of God say? Read with the reader.
Amen.
Together. Esther had not revealed her people or family, for Mordecai had charged her not to reveal it. And every day, Mordecai paced in front of the court of the women's quarters to learn of Esther's welfare and what was happening to her. Now you see why that's so well to walk with all your Bibles?
Amen.
Always walk with your Bible. Perhaps it was not a criterion on the application form to put your nationality, Pastor White. who do not know, but Esther was instructed by Mordecai not to tell her nationality at that time. Mm-hmm. And she listened. May I tell somebody here this evening that there's a time and a place for everything?
Come on, preacher.
There's
come
a
on.
Time to be silent
yes.
and a time to speak.
Amen.
So that was Esther's time to be silent.
Yes.
Sometimes it's important to shut your mouth.
Well.
Forgive my dialect. But perhaps you didn't understand my dialect. So let me say that it's important to keep quiet. Okay, good. In Antigua dialect. In other words, not everything good to talk. To protect your own self. To protect your dreams.
Come on.
Joseph. To protect your plans, your aspirations, and your goals. You know why, my friends? Sometimes some people do not have your best interests at heart.
That's right.
You tell them you plan to open a business in doing so and so. You plan for next year, January, you know.
Well.
By December, they won't open. When we speak too much, we end up hurting ourselves. You see, it's not about being secretive, it's about being wise.
Amen.
It's not about being ashamed, it's about being astute.
Amen.
The moment you spill it, you lose it.
That's correct.
The less you give out, the less details the devil has to work with.
Oh.
And the less he has to work with, the harder it is for him to work against you.
Amen.
You see, he's not omniscient. He's not all-knowing like God.
No.
He takes cues from us.
That's right, preacher.
That's why my mother used to tell me, and I didn't understand it until I became an adult, some prayers you don't even say it out loud. Some prayers you just keep in your mind. Only between you and God. But let's go back to the scripture, Esther 2, 12 to 13. Reader, do you have it?
Yes.
Go ahead, please.
Each young woman's turn came to go into King Ahasuerus after
yes.
she had completed 12 months preparation, according to the regulations of the women. For thus were the days of their preparation apportioned, 6 months with oil of myrrh, and 6 months with perfumes and preparations for beautifying women. Thus prepared each young woman went to the king, and she was given whatever she desired to take with her from the woman's quarters to the king's palace.
In other words, don't miss the point. Esther was beautiful, yes?
Yes.
She was young, yes?
Yes.
She was a virgin, yes?
Yes.
But that was not enough.
No.
She still had to undergo 1 year preparation
right.
along with the other women before they could be declared fit to fill the vacancy of queen.
Mm-hmm.
Before they could be declared fit to wear the crown.
Come on now.
Don't miss it.
Come on. Please.
Don't miss it. The reality is many of us want the position without the preparation.
Come on now.
We want the triumph without the treatment. We want the crown without the cross. We want the fame without the fight. We want the glory without the grind. We want the office without the performance. And sadly, many people want salvation without sacrifice.
Come on now. Come on, preacher.
Esther's preparation took 1 year. Joseph's preparation took about 13 years before he became the prime minister.
Come on now.
And his preparation entailed a prison and a pit.
Yes.
Moses' preparation took 40 years before he was declared fit to be the leader of Israel.
Come on now.
And he was in the wilderness for 40 years.
Yes.
Have come by here to tell somebody, each one of us require preparation.
Yes.
It might be a different type and a different length, but we all require preparation.
Amen.
And for such a time as this has come by here, so that some of us know, in fact, all of us can be prepared for the great crowning when Jesus himself shall crown us.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen, preacher.
what happened after the preparation process was complete. Let's go to Esther 2, 17 to 18. What does the word of God say?
The king loved Esther more than all the other women.
He did what?
He loved her more than all the other women.
Uh-huh.
And she obtained grace and favor in his sight.
And favor, yes.
More than all the virgins. So he set the royal crown upon her head and made her queen instead of Vashti.
Amen. Uh-huh.
Amen.
Verse 18.
Then the king made a great feast,
mm-hmm.
the feast of Esther, for all his officials and servants. And he proclaimed a holiday in the provinces and gave gifts according to the generosity of a king.
So the vacancy created by Queen Vashti moving off the scene
mm-hmm.
was created by the omniscient God.
Come on now.
So that Esther could fill that vacancy.
Come on now. Talk about
it. Despite her past, despite her orphan status.
Come on now.
Despite her Jewish nationality, she became the queen of Persia.
Amen.
Don't miss it, my friends.
Yes.
God is omniscient.
Come on,
he is all-knowing. He
Come
rules
on.
Over the affairs of men and women. He can move out somebody to put you in that
Hallelujah.
Position.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Come on. Come on. Talk
Never
about
doubt
it.
Your God.
Amen.
I heard a story about a man who was seeking employment for years. He sent out application upon application. He sent application to this place that had no vacancy, Sister Shamin. They replied to him, there are no vacancies at this time. He told his wife, in faith, I'm going to get a job there.
Come on now.
How did you know that my God, his God, orchestrated so that the government of the day said you must hire a minority?
Come on now.
And he was a minority.
Amen.
Within a week, they called him. They created a vacancy for a minority.
Praise God. Praise God.
You missed it.
Praise
they
God.
Created a vacancy for a minority.
Come on now. Praise God.
Do you feel as if you are in the minority this evening?
Oh, come on now.
Have you sent out applications after applications? Have you been waiting for a breakthrough for a very long time? For such a time as this,
come on now.
You are here.
Amen.
Turn to somebody and tell them there is a vacancy that only you can fill.
Come on, preacher. Fire it. Fire it.
Your time will come. Your time will come.
Amen.
My time will come. Let them play. Your time will come.
Amen.
All the setbacks are just set up for a comeback.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
But could I tell you something else?
Come on.
There is a vacancy in heaven.
Come on.
That only you can fill.
Talk about it, preacher. Come on now.
There is a tailor-made crown in heaven that fits only you.
Come on now.
Would you allow God to have to toss it into hell because you went into hell?
Mm-hmm.
Or would you walk aright and say, yes, I want my crown? Don't let nobody steal your crown.
Amen. Sound advice, preacher.
Some time passed. And Haman, a high official of the king, if you please.
Well.
Who hated Esther's cousin Mordecai. Who did he hate? But it was not enough for him to destroy Mordecai alone. So he went to the king with a plan to destroy Mordecai and all the people.
Well.
I tried to talk dialect there. Haman convinced the king that these people are against you. These people ought to be wiped out.
Well.
And the king, again listening to bad counsel, he took a signet ring and he gave it to Haman. The Bible calls him the enemy of the Jews. Mm-hmm. Could I tell somebody here? Just now, let me just, before I go to that. Verse 13 says that letters were sent by posts into all the king's provinces to destroy, to kill, and to cause to perish all Jews, both young and old, little children and women, in one day. But could I tell you that there's a Haman still around?
Come on now. Come on.
And he's even worse than Haman.
Come on.
Expose My it. Bible tells me in John 10:10 that the devil has come to do what?
Steal, kill, and destroy.
The same thing Haman wanted to
do. That's right.
The devil ain't playing with you.
No.
The devil has come to do what?
Steal,
to
kill.
To steal. To kill
and
to destroy.
That's right.
He has come to destroy families.
Yes.
Destroy young people.
Yep.
Destroy relationships. Steal your joy and your peace.
Come on now.
And to destroy us at any cost.
Yes.
You like money? Well, he will give you that.
Well.
To keep you in his corner.
Come on.
You like power and position? He will give you that too.
Yeah.
To keep you in his corner.
Well.
The devil will stop at nothing. You heard the people of the gay pride movement. We are coming for your children.
Well.
Oh, Jesus, protect our children.
Yes, Lord.
The devil ain't playing with us, people.
No.
The devil's ultimate aim is that we would share hell's fire with him.
That's right.
But the Bible says that hell's fire was created for the devil and his angels, not for you.
That's right.
Too many people right here in Jennings, you are playing around with the devil. On the devil's territory.
Come on, now.
Could I tell you this evening that you are playing on dangerous grounds?
Yes.
And it's only a matter of time until he wipes you out.
Come on, now.
And you are lost. But I've already told him many years ago, you could go to hell by yourself.
Come on now. Amen, preacher.
I tell him long time, you could go to hell by yourself.
Amen.
But this child of God,
come on,
this now. Little girl here that hails from Mayaro, Trinidad, from a little fishing village, this little girl has decided that she will keep her crown.
Amen. 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 Praise the Lord.
Tell the devil the next time he comes to you, go to hell by yourself.
Well, strong word.
But I thank God that John 10:10 didn't stop there. It says, but Jesus came.
Come on,
hallelujah.
Come on now,
but Jesus came,
hallelujah,
that we might have life.
Come on.
And have it more abundantly.
Praise God, preacher. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Well, now we are back into the narrative. The news of the mass destruction of the Jews passed through. And everyone became so concerned that there was wailing and weeping. Everyone was anxious. When would that day come for them to be destroyed? But there was a one man.
Come on now.
He held a one man protest in the streets, if you please.
Come on now.
Right in front of the palace, he tore his clothes. He put on sackcloth and ashes. He stood alone, something very few of us are willing to do.
Come on now. Come on.
He cried with a loud and bitter cry. Friends here in Antigua and in Trinidad and Tobago, we need to stand together for when things are going wrong.
Come on now.
Too many of us say we are Christians, but we are too timid.
Come on, preacher. Come on.
Esther's maids and eunuchs reported that her uncle, or Mordecai, at that time, I don't know if they knew he was her uncle, what was happening, and she became distressed, sent clothes for him, and he said, no, I don't want no clothes.
Mm-mm.
She sent Hatak to ask him, which is one of the king's chambermaids, ask him what was going on. He said, tell her that there is a plan to kill all the Jews.
Yes.
And big money was paid
for
the debt. Could I tell somebody that big money is paid sometimes even for your debt?
Come on now, preacher. Come on.
Mordecai showed Hatak a copy of the dead decree against the Jews to show it to Esther and to charge her to go into the king and to tell the king to intercede rather for her people. When Esther heard it, she at first was like, huh?
Mm.
He had to be crazy.
Well.
Tell cousin Mordecai that everybody around here know that if man or woman, even me as queen, go before the king without an invitation, there is one law.
Yes.
You shall be put to death.
Mm-hmm.
Save and accept the one whom the king extends his golden scepter.
Right.
And do you know that the king has not called me for 30 days?
Hmm.
Well, let's go to Esther 13 and 14, and let's hear what Mordecai sent back to tell Esther.
And Mordecai told them to answer Esther, do not think in your heart that you will escape in the king's palace any more than all the other Jews. For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for Jews from another place. But you and your father's house will perish. Yet, who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?
In other words, my friends, he told her, Esther, do not forget that you are a Jew. There are many Antiguans who go to Canada, the UK, America, and they come back spitting Yankee too bad. But tell them DNA don't lie. And should anything go wrong, they will send them right back here. Do not think, Esther, that your position as queen will protect you when the decree to destroy the Jews become effective.
Hmm.
And if you do not act,
well,
God will find somebody else to do
God.
It.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
But who knows?
Come on now.
Whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this.
Well,
Esther wore the crown,
mm.
but she did not know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
But thankfully, she listened to wise counsel.
Yes, amen.
Pastor White, leave yet? She leave? Oh, God, she right here. Shucks. I might be able to say that there.
Prophesy, preacher, prophesy.
Sometimes, wait, what side she on? This side? I'll talk on this side. Sometimes, this side alone. Close all the ears. Sometimes, those who are in position of authority, can I go there?
Come on now.
Those who wear the crown.
Come on.
Those who can make things happen, do not always know what to do.
Yeah. Mm.
Don't tell her.
Mm.
So sometimes, just sometimes, they need laymen like Elder Edson or Brother Eugene to tell them what to do. You understand? So Mordecai was like Edson or Brother Eugene, right?
Yeah.
Telling Esther, who was in authority, what to do, right?
Well.
You see, he was in the trenches, so he was feeling the pinch.
Mm.
And sometimes when you're up there sitting on your throne, you don't feel it as much
well,
as those who are out here.
Come on, preacher.
Am I speaking the truth?
Come on, preacher.
So that's why sometimes the lay people are the best persons to give suggestions.
Come on now.
Because they are feeling the pinch with the people in the trenches.
Amen. Amen. Dive in deep, preacher. Dive in deep.
There is a time to be silent.
Come on.
But there's a time to speak.
Come on now.
He told her, your time to be silent is over.
Come on.
Now is the time to act.
Yes.
Now is the time to speak. Go before the king and intercede for your people.
That's right.
The time to act is now.
Come on.
Too long you've been in the same place, marking time.
Come
it's
on.
Time to go forward.
Come on now.
I don't know about you, but I accept the challenge that I've come to the kingdom for such a time as
Amen.
This.
Amen. Amen.
Do I have any other challenge takers?
Amen. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah.
I've come to the kingdom for such a time as this to break down the enemy's stronghold.
Come on now.
To call young people, men and women, to say yes to Jesus.
Amen.
Esther said, gather the people. Pray for them. Pray for me, rather. Pray and fast 3 days. Mm-hmm. And when that is done, I will go before the king.
Mm-hmm.
And if I perish, I perish.
Amen.
Can I tell you this evening?
Tell us.
Jesus left the splendor of heaven. Galatians 4:4 says, but when? The fullness of time had come.
Hallelujah.
When God deemed that the time was right, mm-hmm. God sent his son, Jesus Christ, mm-hmm. born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive the adoption of children.
Glory.
But Joseph went into Egypt at the right time.
Yes.
By God's providence, Moses delivered the people of Israel at the right time.
Yes.
And Esther provided salvation for her people at the right time. Could I tell you that Jesus came at the right time?
Yes, he did. Yes, preacher.
He left heaven.
Come on, preacher.
And he told his father, not if I perish,
no.
but when I perish,
yes.
I will go still. Mm. Because I know that my death will be worth it. I will save my people from their sin.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Friends, tonight, Jesus, he came to the earth at the right time.
Come on now.
Could I tell you that God has called you for such a time as this?
Yes.
God has prepared you for such a time as this. God has kept you alive through COVID for
yes.
such a time as this.
Yes.
God has spared your little island from the recent storm for such a time as this.
Yes.
I've come by here to tell you it is time to wake up.
Come on now.
Time to act. Time to answer the call.
Come on.
The conditions of the world tell us that it is high time to wake up
yes.
out of our sleep.
Hallelujah.
For now is our salvation
Here
closer
mm.
than when we first believed.
Indeed.
The Apostle John on the island of Patmos said, mm-hmm. Behold, I, Jesus, come quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Hold fast which thou hast, that no man take your crown.
Yes,
do I have anybody here this evening
mm-hmm.
who wants to accept the challenge that you've come to the kingdom for such a time as this?
Amen.
Let's stand together.
Amen.
Let's stand together. As we sing that song, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Because my aim and my hope and my desire is that all of us will be there when Jesus comes to receive our crown. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. We all know this song, it's a familiar song, so let's sing it together.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound,
time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather
over on the other shore,
you.
When the roll is called up yonder,
when the roll
is called up yonder, and the
mean it. Oh, yes.
When the wrong is called up yonder, when the wrong is called up yonder, when the wrong is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Let us labor, let us labor.
Let us labor. For a master from the dawn till satisfied. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Do you want to be there? Do you want to be there? Wave your hand if you want to be there. Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Tell yourself that now. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Tell your neighbor, when the roll is called up yonder, I want to see you there. When the roll is called up yonder, I want to see you there. When the roll is called up yonder, I want to see all of us there. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you that you've called us. You've ordained us. You've prepared us for such a time as this. Bless every young person who made the effort to come out this evening. Bless every man, every woman in a special way. Bless their careers. Bless their business, dear Jesus. Protect them from the evil one. Be with them in their going out and in their coming in. And as they come out here, night after night, may they be empowered. May they be blessed to go forth and shine for Jesus. We thank you for everyone who came by here tonight. And we pray that you will go with us now as we depart from this place, but not from your presence. Take us home safely and bring us back tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. when we can hear another word from you. We thank you. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. Bring a friend. Bring a neighbor. Bring an enemy. Bring a frenemy. Bring somebody. If you want to see me after, just wait right out there and I'll see you after. If you want to see one of the elders, just wait there and we'll talk to you. God bless you and we'll see you tomorrow evening.